Welcome to this week's edition of WTHS News. I'm Vasila Dow.
And I'm Claire Bailey. Today is Friday, October 14th, which also happens to be National Dessert Day.
Yum. Here are this week's sweet stories. Here at THS, athleticism is all around us, and some of our sports stars include our cross-country runners.
Let's see how our cross-country team is doing.
Our new cross-country coach is Coach Stankler Shuttles, and she's really great. She's, like, really pushed us hard this season, and she cares about each and every runner, and she also, like, encourages us a lot with, like, devotions and, like, things to pump us up for meets.
The new girls cross-country coach is Jane Claire Shettles. She's really good. Like, we all love her. She prepares us really well for meets.
As a senior, we have to get the team together and start our stretches and get everyone doing what they're supposed to do.
As a senior, we have a lot of runners looking up to us, so we have to have a good attitude and just motivate everyone to do their best.
People just look up to us now, and they depend on us to, you know, get things going and just keep everybody on track.
My favorite thing about being on the team is how it's just so big, and, like, everybody's so close to each other, and, like, we're all, like, one big family.
My favorite thing about being on the cross-country team is just how close we all get and how we can all just push each other and just have a lot of fun while we're running.
So a couple of weeks ago, me, William Bradford, and Nylon Fortenberry went to Walgreens and got a giant cutout of Begno's face.
I joined because I was just, you know, I was kind of decent at running, and I wanted to do a sport, and I wasn't really good at anything else.
I joined cross country because my mom made me.
I knew a lot of the guys on there, and I enjoyed being around them, and I started running, and I just fell in love with it.
We're really ramping up our mileage. Our distance days are getting up to like 9 and 10 miles a day.
We practice every day for fourth block, and we usually about 5 miles a day, varsity about 8.
We prepare by just working really hard for 2 weeks before it, and we just try to improve our times as a team.
Biggest rivals probably Madison Central or Ocean Springs.
Ourselves. Yeah, we're our biggest rival.
Either Saltillo or Starkville.
I usually look forward to the Pontotoc meet because it's usually really, like, good weather. Like, it's kind of cool outside, and the course is really nice, and it's a fast course.
I'm really looking forward to the Clinton meet because it's the course that we run state meet, so it's good practice.
This year has been unusually hot for a very long time now.
And it's finally getting cooler. Let's head on over to our meteorologist, Lila and Catherine, for this week's weather.
That was a good run.
Thanks, Claire. I'm Catherine Stein.
And I'm Lila McGraw, and this is your 7-day forecast. Today, we have a high of 84 and a low of 61, with a 10% chance of rain. Also, there's a football game tonight, so be sure to come out and sport your wave. Tomorrow, Sunday, and Monday, we have highs in the upper 80s and lows in the mid-60s. On to you, Catherine.
Tuesday, we have highs in the low 80s and lows in the mid-60s, with a 20% chance of rain. We also have a half day that day, so make sure you come and eat lunch with me and Lila.
If you're lucky.
Wednesday and Thursdays, we have highs in the mid-80s and lows in the low 50s, with a 10% chance of rain.
Now let's take a closer look at tonight's weather. At 5, it will be 76 degrees with a 0% chance of rain, so come to the game and wear your pink. At kickoff, it'll be 72 degrees with a 10% chance of rain. After the game, it'll cool down to 66 degrees with a 20% chance of rain. Toga will be held at the Link Center, so be sure to make it there with your best dance moves.
See you at the Pole and saw you at the Pole are annual events held by FCA, where students gather to pray over the school and students.
Let's take a look at the members who came together to worship.
The FCA officers, we meet every Wednesday in TA, and we prepare for Friday mornings and special events such as Saw You at the Pole. And sometimes if we don't finish during TA, we meet at someone's house and prepare for it.
Well, as an FCA officer, it just pushes me every day just to be a light to everyone on campus and just to show Christ.
We tried to meet during TA and after school some, and just considered who'd be the best to pray, and we picked scripture to read. And I had to get a bunch of sound equipment from my church and get here really early to set that up.
I'll see you at the Pole. We have got a list, pick people to pray, pick people to do read scriptures, and pick songs to worship, and everybody knows, and it's a good thing.
My responsibility as an FCA officer reflects, like, my character as a Christian. I need to live it out and show people my faith daily.
Well, see at the poll is a great opportunity for all of us to gather and just have a chance to pray for the community and our school and our nation, and just to sing praise songs.
I think just coming together and praying for the community in our world is always helpful. You can always use more prayer in a world that we live in. The most important aspect of Saw You at the Poll is just our school and our Christians coming together and just praying together and praying for our world.
FCA at Tupelo, I just moved here my sophomore year, and it's a lot different because you like do a lot more stuff and you have a lot more people to come to FCA and get to shed Christ throughout the campus easier at Tupelo.
Before we head out, let's get smarter with the Wise Bros, Ray and Jack.
We are taking over the Wise Words show from Tanner Jaggers.
They may have won the battle, but they have not won the war.
Not sure if we can top that, but we can try to carry on the great tradition.
This is a remake by the hit Brainiac.
Randy Riley wrote into the show asking for some advice.
All right, Jack, let me read the letter.
Okay. Jack and Ray, I really like this girl, but I really don't know how to tell her without the fear of embarrassment. I think she likes me back, but I don't know for sure. Any advice on how I can tell her how I really feel?
Well, Randy, a wise man once told me, don't love someone that treats you like you're ordinary.
Ray, I don't think that really goes with what Randy says.
Well, Randy, you're definitely not ordinary, so you need to find you a girl that treats you like you're special.
Randy, I think you need to not focus on girls, but on your talents on the baseball field this year.
Yeah, it's really indeed your athletic ability on the diamond.
And that's it from Wise Bros. We'll see you all in a couple weeks.
Thanks for watching this week's episode of WTHS. Have a happy National Dessert Day.
Do not forget to watch the show next week.